Neuropathy is how the affliction of the nerves happens. We know that the nervous system is divided into a central nervous system consisting of the brain and the spinal cord mainly. There is a peripheral nervous system which involves all the nerves, small nerves, big nerves across the various body parts. And there is an autonomic nervous system which controls the visceral or internal organs of the man. All the three are affected by diabetes. If we take the central nervous system, we know that strokes is a major hazard, but diabetes directly doesn't cause the strokes, but it's a major risk factor along with hypertension, dyslipidemia, smoking, etc. So it is one of the risk factors for causing strokes. Now, if we take the peripheral nervous system, we know that diabetes is one of the major reasons for paralyzing or for creating trouble with the peripheral nerves. The general symptoms of diabetic neuropathy can be classified into two. There are positive symptoms where you will have very strong pain sensations. You can have burning sensation. On the other extreme, we can have no sensations at all, or we can have insensate feet and insensate hands. Feet are more commonly affected. If the particular diabetic is in the habit of using ethanol or alcohol, to the peripheral neuropathy may be still worse, and the deficiency of vitamin B12 also adds on to the woes of people with diabetic neuropathy. Now, coming to autonomic neuropathy, the most common symptom experienced by diabetic is flatulence, or sense of fullness in the tummy. There is stagnation of food, there is improper digestion, there is improper transit of the stool. So all this leads to lot of flatulence, lot of belching, lot of discomfort, inability to eat properly, inability to perceive hunger. So all this is regarding the gastrointestinal system, or autonomic neuropathy that affects the gastrointestinal system. Then we have the genitourinary involvement, wherein first and foremost is the erectile dysfunction. Erectile dysfunction and the sexual abnormalities are very common with diabetic more so in men. It can be there in women as well. The dryness, dyspareunia, or pain during intercourse, all that can be there with women. But the erectile dysfunction is the commonest sexual abnormality that is seen in diabetic men. And then there are other urinary problems, like there is an improper voiding from the urinary bladder. Then there is a frequent urinary tract infections. So all these are a result of autonomic involvement of the urinary system. What can we do to prevent these serious complications in diabetes? Adopt a very healthy lifestyle. Incorporate exercise in your daily routine. So to conclude, I would like to say that always be very careful about your legs. Always try to examine the legs whenever possible. So these are things that can be done in order to minimize the impact of neuropathy.